This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ, Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4, tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture. He is buried, he rose again, third day, according to the Scripture. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. She's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. Send me heal the broken heart, praise the livers to the captives, recovering sight to the blind, set at liberty, then better bruised. The word is nigh thee, even in your heart, in your mouth. There's a word of faith which I preach. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. Everyone that believeth, the Jew first, also to the Greek, therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone receiving this broadcast on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, or other devices. Thank God. Amen. To my right, co-host Terre Brown. Good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. To my left, co-host Kathie Davidson. Good morning.
Good morning.
And further on to your from your left, is co-host Apostle at the Reece. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank God. I was trying to learn how to spell that. Amen. Amen. And on the wire in Colorado, Kathie Courier. Good morning.
Good morning.
Glory. Thank God. We better get the minds out quick, huh?
Rejoice for the steps of a righteous man. They are ordered of God. They are ordered of God. Rejoice for the steps of a righteous man. They are ordered of God. It's time to come on, come and come and serve. Come and sustain. It's time to come on, come and lift you up. So rejoice.
Hallelujah. By God. By God. Does anyone have something from the Lord that you need to deliver? It's open. How about me? Amen. You know, last night, I prayed a prayer. And I don't talk this way often, but the words of that prayer are sweet as a honeycomb. Kathie, would you tell the world that prayer is?
Right. This was posted last night at 10:05. And you said, Father, intervene into all of Water of Life people and bring them into submission to the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.
Is that a prayer?
Like I've said to you, I've heard you pray the word intervene more than once. And you have faith for that word.
I agree with you.
And when that comes up in your heart, faith for that, it doesn't take a long prayer.
No, it doesn't. Amen. Thank God. And then I had a little sleep till 2 or 3, I don't even know. I was thinking about that prayer, what it means. You know, the Lord said to me, He chose me and sent me to the four corners of the earth to deliver His word without fear or despair. Four corners of the earth we go. Those with me, we go to the four corners of the earth to speak a psalm, a revelation, a doctrine, a tongue, an interpretation. Amen. Is that a beautiful thing to do? Four corners. God has sent us. Amen. To declare His word. Amen. So now, this morning, I can see the Lord is gathering His people. Gathering His people. What a blessing. So, I posted this, God did. 1 through 18 or 19, I think. Kathie, would you read John 10?
Sure will. Chapter 10, verse 1. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. And he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them. And the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. This parable spake Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spoke unto them. Then said Jesus unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is a hireling and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming, and he leaveth the sheep and fleeth. And the wolf catches them and scattereth the sheep. The hireling fleeth because he's a hireling and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and I am known of mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And other sheep I have which are not of this fold, them I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life, that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. And I'm going to read verse 26 and 20 through 28. Well, let's read 25. Jesus said unto them, I told you, and you believe not. The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear witness of me. But you believe not, because you are not of my sheep, as I said unto you. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one.
Amen. And those are names.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. There's just one shepherd.
Amen.
Ezekiel 34, I believe it is, teaches that.
Amen.
One shepherd. Amen. One shepherd. Did you know Jesus is everywhere?
Amen.
Amen. What a blessing. One fold. He said, here or two back, he was here in person in Plano. Thank God. He was here to heal me.
Amen.
Amen. To help me. Lord is my helper. I boldly say that.
Amen.
So, we go to the four corners of the earth. A live stream. The Lord knows where his people are, where his children are.
Amen.
And he sends us to them, to speak to them. Amen.
I remember when I first came here in 1984, one of the very first messages I heard you minister was, my sheep hear my voice.
Right.
And you just didn't minister it once, over and over again, till we started hearing.
Amen. Well, if your sheep, you hear the voice of Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen.
I'm sure it's the Lord, and it's the practical part of that is I lived several doors down from a sheep farmer, and he had a small herd of sheep. They were under 100, I think. But it was amazing to watch, because the barn was on one side of this road, a pretty busy highway, and the pasture was on the other side. And all he had to do was call out, and they would all run to the gate.
Amen.
And I had a friend that, Mr. Meekum was the farmer's name, the sheep herder. And he went to go visit some family in another state, and a friend of mine took over the barn, took over the sheep for him to care for him, and they would not come. They would not come to this man. And he was so frustrated because they wouldn't come. He would have to wait until they got hungry enough to come to the gate, and then he would take them across the street.
Amen. Thank God. What a great blessing to be known by God.
Oh, yeah.
By Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Know our name. Know where we're at.
Amen.
Know where every one of us are at. Thank God. I say, last night was the beginning of gathering. What are my people? That's what he said. Have me pray, Father, intervene. Intervene. That you know when you are brought under the lordship of Jesus, he's going to be your Lord. And you've got protection. Oh, he watches you all the time. He knows what you're doing. Amen. He's going to talk to you. There are people that I've known for years. Today, they're going to hear the voice of Jesus, maybe more than they ever have. They're his children. They're his sheep. Amen. They are his sheep. We are the Lord's sheep. Amen. He knows our name. He knows where we're at. He knows what we need. He watches you. Not only that, but he has command of the angels. And if he needs more help, he gets the angels, commands them, and they come. What a wonderful thing to know that angels are watching you. Jesus is watching you. He's the good shepherd. Now, you know what I see? Water of life. And I'm the apostle. Anthony's an apostle. David Gaspar's an apostle. We got some more rising up. They're here. They're becoming effective. Amen. I say the people that are the Lord's and John then, we're speaking to all of them. Never said that before. I've never said that before, but we are speaking to all of God's people on the earth. On the earth. Now, did not Kathie read that there was a group of people that were not his sheep? Did you read that?
It says, and other sheep, verse 16, and other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, Them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd.
Amen. One fold, one shepherd. The shepherd is Jesus. Amen. Amen. And the Lord has sent me to the four corners of the earth to declare his word. So he sent me to you.
Amen. May I read that in Ezekiel?
Yeah, 34.
Right. And it begins in verse 11. For thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will both search my sheep and seek them out. As a shepherd seeketh out his flock in the day that he is among his sheep that are scattered, so will I seek out my sheep and will deliver them out of all places where they have been scattered in the cloudy and dark day. And I will bring them out from the people and gather them from the countries and will bring them to their own land and feed them upon the mountains of Israel by the rivers and in all the inhabited places of the country. And I will feed them in a good pasture, and upon the high mountains of Israel shall their fold be. And there they shall lie in a good fold, and in a fat pasture shall they feed upon the mountains of Israel. And I will feed my flock, and I will cause them to lie down, saith the Lord God. And I will seek that which was lost, and bring again that which was driven away. And I will bind up that which was broken, and will strengthen that which was sick. But I will destroy the fat and the strong. I will feed them with judgment.
Amen. Thank God. Where? Moving in to a new place in the body of Christ.
Amen.
We're going up in the Spirit. And it's exciting to me because we're speaking. The Lord may speak through us to every person on the four corners of the earth.
Amen.
Not just me, Terre, Kathie, Anthony, Casper, Paul Peters, Brian Bonner, Aaron Turner. Amen. You say, you know anybody else? No, if I did, I'd be saying it. I got it back. Amen. This, I believe, is a gathering of God's people who will meet Jesus. And
I believe it's in the book of Luke that it talks about where the carcass is, there will the eagles be gathered together.
Right. Now, of course, one's in the grave. They're coming out.
Amen.
Amen. But this to me is an encouragement to believe that Jesus is going to come back before too long. Amen. You know, he has told me I'm going to be here for the great tribulations. And that many would come to me for instruction. Amen. Not just me, but Terre, Kathie, Anthony, Brian, Paul, Casper, Aaron, Turner, others. Oh, by the way, Ted Ross in California is with us. We got other people with us that we are not communicating with at the moment, but God is bringing them together. Amen. Amen. I like a stranger's voice they will not hear.
Well, I have a song.
You do?
Yes.
Let's sing it.
I haven't done this one in a long time, but it came in my heart here. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he's waiting and watching, watching for you and for me. Come home, come home. You who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling, oh sinner, come home. Oh, for the wonderful love he has promised, promised for you and for me. Though we have sinned, he has mercy and pardon, pardon for you and for me. Come home, come home. You who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home.
Hallelujah. Heard that many times.
It's an old one, isn't it?
Amen.
I wasn't sure if I could remember it.
Hallelujah. All the people in Zimbabwe. Amen. The Lord's people. God has sent us to you. Africa. China, Japan, amen, thank God, hallelujah, four corners, amen, amen, God has sent us to declare his word. That's all beautiful. You see, God has really blessed this ministry. It's his, not mine. Belongs to God, the Lord. Amen. Amen. I'm going to say good morning to Steady, Susan, Zimbabwe. I guess it's a good evening there, isn't it?
Amen. They just finished their leaders' conference yesterday.
Amen. My God. Amen. Glory.
With that, can we read Matthew 18 about the 100 sheep?
Well, go ahead.
Matthew 18, verse 11. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. How think you? If a man have 100 sheep and one of them be gone astray, does not he leave the 99 and goeth into the mountains and seek that which is gone astray? And if it be so, he find it. Verily I say unto you, he rejoices more of that sheep than of the 99 which went not astray. Even so, it is not the will of your Father which is in heaven that one of these little ones should perish.
Amen. You're not lost. The Lord knows where you're at.
Amen.
You're not hiding either. He knows exactly where you're hiding.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the Lord said to Elijah, what are you doing here? May have been an angel. What are you doing here, Elijah? But man, he didn't think it was anybody but him. I remember Argyle. I couldn't tell there was anybody except me serving the Lord. I tell you, when I was in Argyle, somebody came out with some tapes about the end time, and they said to me, have you got those tapes? No. You don't? No. Do you want them? No. You don't want to listen to them? No. I'm going to be here. Did you know the man that came out with those tapes is in heaven? You know I'm sitting here speaking to the four corners of the earth. I didn't need to hear what he had to say. I was serving God. I was following Jesus. He was taking up, I was taking up my cross daily and following Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Kathie, good reading. 18. Matthew 11 through what? 18 or 19?
11 through 14.
Through 14?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. My God, what time is it?
It is 10:34.
10:34?
Yes. Anthony has something.
Oh, good.
Well, I was going to say here, Jesus has a prayer in John chapter 17, and he says that he prays this prayer not for those that are in the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are mine. Amen. They are thine. If I could, I'd like to read that prayer.
Read it.
This is John chapter 17. It says, these words spake Jesus, this is verse 1, and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour is come, glorify thy Son, that thy Son may glorify thee. As thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should have eternal life, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. For I have given unto them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. And all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee, Holy Father. Keep through thine own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. Those that thou gavest me I have kept, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. And now come I to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and the world hath hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. As thou hast sent me unto the world, even so have I also sent them into the world.
Amen.
For their sakes I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. Neither pray I for these alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word, that they all may be one, even thou, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me, and glorify, and the glory which thou gavest me I have given them, that they may be one, even as we are one, I in them, and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them as thou hast loved me. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world hath not known thee, but I have known thee, and these have known that thou hast sent me. And I have declared unto them thy name, and will declare it, with that the love wherewith thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. He said, I pray that thou shouldest not take them out of the world, but thou shouldest keep them from the evil. We are going to be walking through that tribulation, and Jesus is with us,
amen,
keeping us from the evil.
Amen. Amen. Good word. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank God. What time is it, Kathie?
It is 10:38.
38? Amen. Thank God. Anything else off the set? You know, I'm sure you can tell there's a change in our direction. There's an addition. We're moving on to another location, another level, another purpose of God. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Negative. 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 Amen. Amen.
Now, Anthony brought up a beautiful point just then by the Spirit of God, that through the tribulation, Jesus is going to be with us.
Sure.
He's not going to leave us. And I will tell you this, in a denominational church that I grew up in, we were taught that once that tribulation started, the Holy Ghost was going to go back into heaven. And we were going to be left with our own devices. Left alone, because I remember sitting in the floor in my bedroom. I was about 17 at the time, and I remember thinking, you mean it's going to get worse than this? But you know, that word of God, Jesus said that Holy Spirit will be with you forever. Forever. That means even after, in the millennium, and when New Jerusalem comes, that Holy Ghost will be with us forever. Well, you know, you can't have the Holy Ghost unless you get the Spirit of Jesus in you. So what we have now, the Spirit of Jesus and the Holy Ghost in us, will be with us forever.
Amen. Thank God. You know, I don't even want to say it. I've heard some of the silliest things. Thank God.
You had a relative that told you you couldn't have gotten the Holy Ghost. Because between the time that he got the Holy Ghost and you got the Holy Ghost went to heaven.
God wanted you to tell that.
But the Word of God says he will be with you, the Comforter will be with you forever.
Amen. Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank God. Glory. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank God. Are we ready for turning by?
Amen.
And what are black boys? You know, they've been singing with him when he was here.
Amen.
Amen. And are singing with him now.
Amen.
Even those that have left Water of Life, God knows where you're at.
Amen.
Amen.
They have hundreds of hours of singing with him. Hundreds and hundreds.
Amen.
All that in their heart, rolling around in there.
Waking them up in the middle of the night.
Amen. Glory. Are we ready for those songs?
Amen.
Let's go.
Rose of Sharon, you're a love, you're a was dark in my heart. You brought light to me, a child of darkness became a child of light. And when my soul was so
in his eyes, saying his
Thank you.
give a joyous shout in the honor of the rock of our salvation. Come before him with thankful hearts. Let us sing him songs of praise. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Let us sing him songs of praise. For the Lord is the great God, the King of all gods. For the Lord is the great God. He controls the formation of the depths of the earth, and the mightiest mountains all are His. Alleluia, 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 for the mightiest mountains all are His.
till now we've been looking through a glass so dark and dim, and only a few mysteries have we known. But I sense now
here.
Hallelujah. Amen. Friends, I believe that God is preparing to gather his people. Jesus is gathering them up, bring them in to submission, becoming their Lord. Is Lord of Lord, you know. Jesus, King of Kings. Amen. Amen. God has certainly put a prayer in my heart that the Lord, that God, intervene and bring God's people to submission, to submit to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Amen. I think it's a wonderful time. I think it's the gathering of the people at the end. Amen. Look, God's not going to just pick you up the last minute. You're going to learn to walk under the Lordship of Jesus. Be led by the Spirit of God. That's what I see taking place. They got it bad. That's my prayer. Jesus, be Lord of all of you. All of us. Thank God that we learn to be led by the Spirit. Thank God. Amen. This is a glorious time to me and you. All of us. Amen. Anyone up here got anything they'd like to say? Amen. Amen. Thank God. Well, we'll be back tomorrow. That's for sure. Live stream all over the world. Amen. God took me off of TV. 17 July, I think it was. And I didn't know what was happening. But we were on live stream. And we're here 9+ hours a week. Amen. Live. Preaching the gospel. Ministering to God's people. Speaking the words that God wants said to his people. Amen. Well, mercy, grace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Amen.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas, 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.